Isran will decide if you've got what it takes. Go on, he's right inside.
Why are you here, Tolan? The Vigilance and I were finished with each other a long time ago.
You know why I'm here. The Vigilants are under attack everywhere. The vampires are much more dangerous than we believed.
And now you want to come running to safety with the Dawn Guard, is that it? I remember Keeper Cossette telling me repeatedly that Fort Dawn Guard is a crumbling ruin, not worth the expense and manpower to repair. And now that you've stirred up the vampires against you, you come begging for my protection.
Isran. Cossette is dead. The Hall of the Vigilance, everyone, they're all dead. You were right, we were wrong. Isn't that enough for you?
Yes, well, I never wanted any of this to happen. I tried to warn all of you. I am sorry, you know? So who are you? What do you want? Got a fire in your belly to kill vampires, eh? Good for you. But look around. There's really not much to join yet. I've only just started rebuilding the Order. I need someone out in the field taking the fight to the damn vampires, while we're getting the fort back into shape. Tolan was telling me about some cave the Vigilants were poking around in. Seemed to think it was related to these recent vampire attacks. Tolan, tell him about... what was it? Dim Hollow.
Yes, that's it. Dim Hollow Crypt. Brother Adelwald was sure it held some long-lost vampire artifact of some kind. We didn't listen to him any more than we did Isran. He was at the hall when it was attacked.
That's good enough for me. Go see what the vampires were looking for in this Dim Hollow Crypt. With any luck, they'll still be there. Here, you should take a crossbow. Good for taking out those fiends before they get close. Feel free to poke around the fort and take what you need. There isn't much yet, but you're welcome to anything you can use.
I'll meet you at Dim Hollow. It's the least I can do to avenge my fallen comrades.
Tolan, I don't think that's a good idea. You Vigilants were never trained for...
I know what you think of us. You think we're soft, that we're cowards. You think our deaths proved our weakness. Instead, our grand and you do not have to face the same test and be found wanting.
You there, boy. Stop skulking in the shadows and step up here. What's wrong?
Or attacking the goats or something.
My paw's axe. Stendhal preserves.
something.
A fight.
Vigilants never know when to give up. I thought we'd taught them enough of a lesson at their hall.
To come in here alone. something out there. Do not die. Someone there. Ha! There you are.
down there.
I'll never tell you anything, vampire. My oath to Stendar is stronger than any suffering you can inflict on me.
I believe you, Vigilant. And I don't think you even know what you found. So go up with that.
There you are.
I'll never tell you anything, vampire. My oath to Stendar. It's stronger than any suffering you could.
Something's not right.
What's that?
I knew I smelled mortal blood.
Ah!
sent you here? I was expecting someone like me, at least. Can't you tell just from looking at me? A vampire. That's complicated. And I'm not totally sure if I can trust you. But if you want to know the whole story, help me get back to my family's home. My family used to live on an island to the west of Solitude. I would guess they still do. By the way, my name is Serana. Good to meet you. Your guess is as good as mine. This place looks pretty different from when I was locked away. I'd rather not get into that with you, if that's all right. I'm sorry, it's not that... It's just that I don't know who I can trust yet. Let's get to my home, and I'll have a better sense of where we all stand. Yes, it is. And it's mine. It's complicated. I can't really talk about it. I'm sorry.
Who's there?
good to breathe again.
Even in this weather, it's better than the cave.
This is the...
Okay, so, before we go in there...
I think so. And thanks for asking.
I wanted to thank you for getting me this far. But after we get in there, I'm going to go my own way for a while.
I think...
I know your friends would probably want to kill everything in here. I'm hoping you can show some more control than that. Once we're inside, just keep quiet for a bit. Let me take the lead.
Lady Serana's back! Open the gate!
Let's get indoors. Or in a cave. Anywhere, just out of this.
The way I hear it, Lady Serana's been gone a real long time. How dare you trespass here?
Wait, Serana? Is that truly you? I cannot believe my eyes. My lord, everyone! Serana has returned.
I guess I'm expected.
I can't believe it.
My long-lost daughter returns at last. I trust you have my Elder Scroll.
After all these years, that's the first thing you ask me? Yes, I have the scroll.
Of course, I'm delighted to see you, my daughter. Must I really say the words aloud? Ah, if only your traitor mother were here. I would let her watch this reunion before putting her head on a spike. Now tell me, who is this stranger you have brought into our hall?
This is my savior, the one who freed me.
For my daughter's safe return, you have my gratitude. Tell me, what is your name? I am Harkon, lord of this court. By now, my daughter will have told you what we are. Not just vampires. We are among the oldest and most powerful vampires in Skyrim. For centuries we lived here, far from the cares of the world. All that ended when my wife betrayed me and stole away that which I valued most. You have done me a great service, and now you must be rewarded. There is but one gift I can give that is equal in value to the Elder Scroll and my daughter. I offer you my blood. Take it and you will walk as a lion among sheep. Men will tremble at your approach, and you will never fear death again. Then you will be prey, like all mortals. I will spare your life this once, but you will be banished from this hall. Perhaps you still need convincing. Behold the power! This is the power that I offer. Now, make your choice. Be still. Awake at last. Good. The power is growing within you, and now you must learn to wield it. With my guidance, you will become a deadly instrument, striking terror into the hearts of mortals wherever you tread. Now listen to my words and do as I instruct. The true power of the ancient blood is found in the form of the Vampire Lord. Assume the mantle of the Vampire Lord, and we will continue. My end of the bargain. Now I expect you to keep yours. Indeed.
Where'd you come from?
Should you run out of magicka, you can descend to the ground and fight as the beasts do. Do so now, and we will continue. Good. You are weaker while on the ground, because you cannot access the blood magic. However, the night powers are still yours to command, and your claws are still formidable weapons. Over time, your powers will grow in strength and you will find new ways to use your gifts. There is much to learn, but if you master the powers of the Vampire Lord, few enemies will be able to stand against you. There is one last thing you must know. Slaying mortal men with your life drain grants you new night powers and blood magic. I keep a stable of thralls in the castle, should you need to feed like the baser vampires to stave off the sun. That is all I have to teach you. If you wish to be reminded of these lessons, you need only ask. I have a task that will test your new powers. Good. Go and speak to Garen Marethi. Tell him it is time. He will understand.
Hello there.
Until next time, I'm sure Lord Harkon is... Lord Harkon, remember your place. Now, what is our Lord's wish? Well, well. He wants the chalice, then. You've heard of the Bloodstone Chalice? It is a rather well-kept secret. The chalice has been in Lord Harkon's possession for quite some time now. It is, when used properly, able to increase the potency of our powers. He has neglected using it for ages. If he wants it filled now, then grander things are afoot. This is good. Follow me. I'll take you to it. Lord Harkon has never cared to use the chalice, relying on his more than adequate powers until now. This is an intriguing change. Excuse us. I need to fetch the Bloodstone Chalice.
The Chalice? Why?
What are you up to, Garan?
Lord Harkon's orders, Orthiolf. Calm yourself.
Our friend here has been ordered to fill the chalice.
Really?
Indeed. He's off to Redwater Den.
Well then, best of luck to you.
Vingalmo and Orthiolf are Harkon's primary advisors. I'm sure they're quite surprised to learn that you're taking the chalice. And here we are. Now, this chalice needs to be filled directly from the blood spring that is the source of Redwater Den. But that's not enough. Once that's done, the blood of a powerful vampire needs to be added to it. Keep in mind that Redwater Den has fallen into, well, let's just say less reputable members of society now dwell there. It's your choice whether to attempt to deal with them or force your way through. Hurry back. You don't want to keep Lord Harkon waiting.